In this video, we'll see how to cut a triangle in two equal parts with a line passing through a given point inside the triangle. To start, let us investigate. Here is a triangle ABC, a point O that can be dragged inside the triangle, and a line passing through O that can be rotated like this. And we have colored the two parts obtained thanks to this line, the blue and the orange one. And we have displayed the area, and we can see that if we rotate this line, there is a position where we can obtain the same area nearly here, you see? And we can try everywhere, can do a lot of other trials, you know, and in this position for O, we can see that it's possible to find a position where the area are the same, nearly here. So it's possible. And if you are patient, you could notice more than that. When the point O is inside one of these six triangles defined by the three medians. For example, in this one, you have noticed that the solution of our problem was here, in the opposite triangle, yeah, nearly here, you see? When the point O is inside one of this triangle, the solution, the line solution must be from one point of this triangle to one point of this one. Let us see if it's possible here. Or nearly here. And you can try also in the last case. In this case, if you have the point O, which is here, for example, the line will join one point here to one point here. Well, let us try if it's possible. Something like this. Okay, so let us see now what we can do. When the point O is here, so in this position, we know that the solution can be the line MP, where M is a point of this triangle and P a point of this triangle, and we can check that it's possible if we construct these two. So you see, we are lucky because it's the accurate position. So when we want to find the solution, we have to find only the position of M, and after that we can deduce the position of P. How to do that? Let us establish a preliminary result. So point O is here, we expect to find point M here because O is inside this triangle. So let us start with a line parallel to BC. And after that, the parallelogram BFED, such as the area of this parallelogram is half of the area of ABC. We don't know where is D, why there is this sign here. So we don't know where is D. We have to find where is D in order to verify this relation. So let us use this notation. The altitude AH, K the point at the force of the altitude, AH divided by K. So the area of BFED of the parallelogram is HH prime multiplied by BD, and half of the area of BC, because the area of ABC, sorry, is half of AH multiplied by BC. You have one fourth of AH divided by BC. And because one fourth of AH is equal to HK, we have this equality. And if we continue, we can obtain from the quality of this product with this one, this equality. Let us continue. So we have obtained this quality. You see that HH prime divided by HK is here. So if we construct this parallel line, we know that HH prime divided by HK is also equal to BF divided by BG. So these two ratios are equal. They are here. Let us interpret this equality. This equality means that two lines are parallel because BF divided by BG is here and BC divided by BD is here. So D must be a point, D must be a point of this line, which is not the case here. If we display the area of ABC and A half of the area of ABC and next the area of the parallelogram, these areas are not equal because D is not at the good position. So let us drag this point nearly here and you think that it's nearly equal. But if we validate at an upper level in using the tool redefine this point at the intersection point between the two lines, you see the equality expected. Let's go back. So what do we do now after having established this lemma? We know how to construct a point D such as this parallelogram is half of the triangle for the area. So let us see the construction of the solution. So we have started by the construction of such a point D. So point D is such as the gray parallelogram as an area which is half of the area of ABC. So we want to find the position of M such as the triangle is cut in two parts. So here we want to do that. And we will use these notation. So you see, we want the area of BMP equal half of the area of ABC, which is the area of BFED. With our notation is half of H plus K multiplied by BM and must be equal to HBD, we know that. But also we have the area of PFO, which is equal to the area of the trapezoid OMDE. Why? Because this triangle BMP has an area equal to the area of the parallelogram. But if we cut this part from both, which is left is PFO and this trapezoid. So this equality means that the area of PFO is the area of a triangle, half of KFO, and here the area of this trapezoid, you see here, this trapezoid, and half of the height, which is high H, multiplied by the sum of the bases, which is MD plus OE. So let us see what we can do with these two equalities. I will not spend a lot of time. Take the time on the video to look at what I did here. The first part of these computations leads to this equality. The second part, starting from the second equality, leads to this one. And now we have to manage with the equality of this two ratio and obtain, starting from this equality, we obtain this one. And you will see that thanks to this equality, which is a Pythagoras equality, we will succeed to construct such a point M. So let us remind that we want to find a point M that md square equal oe square minus of square. So final solution. We start from ABC and we construct point D such as a parallelogram BFED is half of the triangle ABC. So we begin to construct this circle, half a circle, diameter OE, and the second one centered in O, radius OF, and let us consider this intersection point U, and because this arc is half a circle, this triangle is a right angle triangle, and so we have the Pythagoras equality which is here. But we know that OU equal OF, so OU can be replaced by OF, okay? And after that, we construct such a parallelogram, and because it's a parallelogram, UE can be here replaced by DV. We do that, DV. And after that, we construct this circle, part of the circle, centered in D, and cutting BC on M. And because DV equal DM, we can replace DV by DM or MD. And this is the equality we want to be verified by point M. So point M is the solution point. And because M is the solution point, this line is the line solution. Let us validate that in constructing these two parts and displaying the areas of such parts. And you can see with the accuracy of the software, we have exactly the same result. And we can change the position of A. It will be always the same thing. That completes this video.